Harvey, and this is Porna Dapapudi, and we're pleased to welcome you to this year's Schools for Schools concert. For those of you who don't know, Schools for Schools is one of the awesome clubs we offer here in the high school every year. We are partnered with a nonprofit organization called Invisible Children, which works out of several African countries, such as Uganda, to provide education to children. They also help prevent poaching wildlife. And to raise money for this cause, we have a concert every year. This year, the program consists of students showing their variety of talents, including poetry, music, dance, and comedy. Without further ado, give a warm welcome to one of your hosts, Jackson Dupree.
I'm so honored to be able to help host the Schools for Schools this year with Porna.
We're so excited to have this opportunity.
Maybe we should test our audience so they can get a glimpse of the things we learned and what this great organization does.
I think that's a great idea. Okay, so here are the instructions. Everybody take out their device. Then you go, if you want to participate, go to kahoot.it and then enter the pin on the screen. After you enter the pin on the screen, you have to enter your name. Please enter your real name. Only the 21st people who put in the pin will be able to participate because of limited numbers. We'll give you guys a few minutes to put in the pin. And the winner gets a gift basket.
All right, so this is how you play. There will be five questions. The question will be shown on the screen with the answers in different colored boxes. Choose the box that corresponds with the correct answer. And here's the question, so you can start.
The question
is at the top of the screen, folks.
Okay.
Which consonant is this? Official languages of Uganda. No.
What's that? Do
you? Yeah. Okay.
Ooh, that's good.
Yeah.
has a kind of D, so I assume that's Dovey. You can go to
Well, that was exciting. You guys really know your stuff.
Definitely was, but you know what's more exciting?
What?
Our first performers.
Oh yes, these boys and girls have been working so hard, and we can't wait to see how they perform.
Please welcome to the stage, third and fourth grade chorus.
Thank you.
kind of went down because I can't really sing. Just ask anyone.
Guys, I'll back her up. She is a terrible singer.
I didn't need that. Okay, anyways, our next performer is a fifth grader who has a knack for the stage. Please welcome Noah Kimbrough.
Now, if you're one of those people who are like, bah, Come, bud. You can sing just fine. I will give you exactly what you want and prove my point at the same time. Let me sing you a couple of bars, and please cover your ears if you're sensitive to frustrating noises. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. You see what I mean? So, to spare you all, I'm taking the much less uncomfortable route and doing stand-up comedy, because that's better, right? Now, something that I have a lot of is anxiety. And the weird thing about it is that I get it from my parents. Some of it's inherited, like how my brother, you just saw him, he gets a lot of his theatrics from my mom. But not everything's about you, Noah. It's my turn. Anyway, some of it I inherit, but most of it I get because they warned me about a lot of things when I was very, very little. Like, from the age of 2, they had warned me not to do stand-up comedy, which is ironic. But they had also warned me about getting kidnapped, and that is something I still have a fear of today. But I'm not talking about getting, like, lured in. For me, I'm not really worried about that. I'm talking about getting picked up by an adult person and taken away from my friends and family. And that doesn't really work for me because I weigh 120 pounds. The only time anybody would try to pick me up, ever, is at like a carnival. We'd need a carnival barker standing there and be like, step right up, step right up. See if you are strong enough to lift the unliftable boy. To help with a lot of my anxieties, though, I've been going to see a therapist, and it's been going great. At first, I didn't want to do it at all, but it's become the highlight of my week. And my therapist has gotten to know me so well, to the point where he can know what kind of meeting we're going to have by just looking at me. Like one time, I had a really bad day, and I was standing in the lobby waiting for him. He was walking down the hallway talking to another patient. He was like, all right, you're doing great. I got to talk to one more patient, and I'm done for the day. Oh, boy. This one's gonna be a doozy. That meeting actually ended up going really well. Something that we're constantly working on though in my anxiety, in my therapy, is my social anxiety that I also have a lot of. That kind of inhibits my ability to make close friends, relationships with people. But since going to therapy, I've gotten out there more, and I've made quite a large friend group for myself, and I keep it tight with all of them. You could ask all 2 of them, they'd say great things. And they're more social than I am. They go to parties and stuff. They're like, hey, are you going to that party this weekend? And I'm like, I got plans. They're like, what kind of plans? And they blink and I'm gone. They're like, where did he go? I'm already at home in my weighted blanket watching comedians in cars getting coffee. That's my weekend schedule, it's done. But something I can't escape, even when I'm at home in my weighted blanket, is my little sister, Brittany. She's somewhere in this audience. She is what gives me a distinct fear of 5-year-olds. She's about yay high. She's about yay high. And it's what my mom would call fierce. I would call her a little murderous. Because she has the habit of kicking, scratching, biting, and punching. She also has a habit of beating me with swords, but that's not the point. The funny part is, you could ask her right now and be like, are you mean? And she'd be like, oh, no, I ain't do nothing to no one. I'm 5 years old. Look at how cute I am. But the moment we get home, the terror begins. She is the most violent child I have ever seen. But when there's a violent child out to get you, you have to stay kind of active. You have to come up with survival techniques. Which I have. One of the best ones, the most effective, is impressions of her favorite cartoon characters. That works really well, but then it gets kind of weird when I'm out in public places, like the mall, for example. And people are like, hey, how are you? Like, hey, how are you? I'm good. Did you catch the game last night? I did. It was crazy. You know how people talk? And I'm over there like, yeah, hi, Colonel. How are you today? And they all turn and look at me funny. It's weird because my impressions have carried over into my normal life. Like sometimes I'm walking into rooms and I go, ah, Foley. One time I was at a rehearsal for a play I did recently, and one of my castmates was kind of leaving. He like reached for the doorknob, and I went, "Christopher Robin, why must you always leave?" He froze up. He slowly turns the doorknob and shuffles away, still looking at me. But something that has been inhibited by my anxieties is my wanting to and my ability to play sports. And I haven't tried it for a sport in 7 years. That has led to a severe lack of knowledge. I pick up key phrases here and there, but it ends up reading like a madman. For example, the team has the puck. They're dribbling it around the bases. The ump swings the putter. It's going, it's going, it's gone. Goal! And the crowd goes wild. Touchdown, home run, strike. In the end, though, I'm lucky enough to have friends, family, a therapist who all care enough to help me. One of the key players in my battle against anxiety are my parents. The ones who are A, breathing into bags, and also, they're putting up with my anxieties constantly. They put up with my sensory issues. I can't wear tags in my shirts, they put up with that. I wear long clothes in 90 degree weather, they put up with that. They're the only people in my life who I know who will drop me off at school in 90 degree weather, in my winter gear with no tags in it, and be like, "All right, son, have a good day, make good choices." Then they roll up the window really slowly, grab a cup of coffee, chug their 50th cup of coffee, and say, "What have we done to the poor boy?" Thank you, everybody. I'm Jack Kimbrough.
I did. It was right in my ear.
You know, but you're used to it because of all the times I laugh at you in a day. And at basketball games, hence the name Can't Make a Three Do Bree.
I guess I am pretty funny sometimes.
Our next group of performers are 3 8th grade girls. These girls practice Indian classical dance outside of school, and we're so excited to get a little taste of what they do. Please welcome Hridaya Patel, Nacha Ramanathan, and Tanisha Kumar. But no, no, I really was not good. And you know, as I grew older, I kind of realized that, you know, I had zero talent when it came to dancing. And you guys might think, you know, she has zero talent at anything. She can't sing, she can't dance. That's not true. I can play golf and soccer and other things, but you know, music just not my thing. It's not Jackson's either.
That was really well done. Our next act is something a little bit different. This senior is known around our upper school for her amazing talent in writing poetry. And trust me, her work is outstanding. Please welcome to the stage, Gabby Williams.
Understand, to comprehend, look forward.